Going on YouTube. It's your boy Galway, back once again for another reaction. I fucked up the order of these letters by Cadet and Krept. When someone told me to do them, I wrote it down. I've got a notepad full of what everyone's been asking me to react to, so I just cross them off once I have reacted to it. And I had Krept letter to Cadet first, Cadet letter to Krept, and then Krept last letter to Cadet in that order. So I fucked up. I didn't realize it's not going to be that big of a difference, really, but I'm sure more things will make sense in the Krept song now that I've heard this, because there were some bars where I'm like, I don't get it, I don't get what he's trying to say. But again, thank you for all the support. Plenty more coming. Shiro's story part 3 is sitting there waiting to be uploaded. It's a long video, 21 minutes just for the video alone. So the reaction itself, if you are new to the channel, I tend to break shit down a lot. So it's a long one. I don't know if people are going to be able to sit through it. If they are, I appreciate it, because it is a long one. And yeah, let's jump straight into this. So as always, jump on the socials there, which I did add. Just a little thing, if you want to connect with me on other platforms, there's Twitter and Instagram there. If you want to send me songs through them, I think that's a much easier way than in the comments this way, because you can actually send me direct links. But yeah, let's jump into it. This is Cadet, Letter to Krept.
Cousin, we'll talk and I even know how to start this. I just know that I love you. Anyway, let me talk, cousin, let me be real. Let me tell you how a nigga.
Damn, he starts that like, dear cousin, I didn't even know how to start this, but I just know that I love you. Like, let me be real. Okay, Cadet. You'll know how much I fucking have enjoyed listening to this guy's songs so far. I got a feeling this is gonna be deep. I'm gonna go record. This will be uploaded the same day. It's the 31st. Right now for me, so I'm literally gonna record, edit this. While that one's rendering, I'm gonna go record last letter to Cadet by Krept. So these are gonna come one after the other, so you're gonna see both of these reactions real quickly.
Start this. I just know that I love you. Anyway, let me talk, cuz let me be real. Let me tell you how a nigga feel from the dinner table, college or in the field. Let me get it out and let me spill every emotion. Know that it's gonna be real. Do you remember how it used to be? Your blame, Cadet and Krept, battling bench, fam would have said, I would walk, you would walk, I would step, you would step, but shit ain't really feeling the same. That's the reason why I'm writing you, because really I just want my cousin back. I ain't got family that's as tight as you, like, I don't really know where to start, but college is kind of when the shit went pear. See, I found my wife in college, but I never made it into the second year when I heard she was cheating. And I was trying to figure it out like it was Blue's Clues, but then you was friends with a guy she was beating. I kind of felt like you let her get moved to, cause I felt snaked, but I never said nothing, I never opened my mouth.
Okay, so that's where the bad blood comes in. Makes a little bit more sense. He's talking about how his ex cheated on him, and Krep knew the guy that she was fucking, and he felt like he didn't help Cadet out, like he didn't let him know, hey, this is what's going on. He kind of felt like he was a little bit, as in his words, snaked. I get it. That's making a little bit more sense now.
Felt like you let her get moved to, cuz I felt snaked, but I never said nothing, I never opened my mouth, cuz maybe you never knew. You know you're my cousin, you get the benefit of the doubt. Now imagine how gas granddad would be seeing us on the stage where we're meant to be. But has it been an easy road? Man, it's been like chapters on the first one's jealousy. Well, maybe not.
Who has been like chapters in the first one's jealousy? Okay.
But it hasn't been an easy road. Man, it's been like chapters on the first one's jealousy. Well, maybe not jealousy, but that word should give you an idea when a drift. And she said we'd be first cousins when I see IG music there. Always comparing a kid like everywhere I go. Everybody saying something, why don't he bring you in? Like a nigga they were young and got me bugging, got me feeling that the love is awful. And they used to, I should have been a paranormal. Now around that time.
That flow through there was cold. Fucking hell. I'm gonna reel that back because that was cold as fuck, that flow.
See music there, always comparing a kid like everywhere I go. Everybody saying something, why don't you bring you in? Like a nigga they were young and got me bugging, got me feeling that the love is awful. And they used to, I should have been a paranormal. Now around that time. I went from being cadet to Krept's cousin and see. Yeah, I was kicking myself.
Okay, so there it makes, again, it makes sense in that other one. You're not, you're Krept's cousin, rah rah rah. Went from being cadet to being Krept's cousin. Okay, it makes so much more sense. I really wish I had done this in proper order. I really wish, because I would have been able to understand that one a lot better. But at least I'm going to be able to do the last one, which I have been told is a bit of a tearjerker, and I am a sucker for emotional shit. I'm probably going to cry. I won't lie. I cry in fucking every movie. I can't help it. I get so emotionally invested in shit, and I just fucking, a little bit of bro tears coming out. I don't give a fuck.
Around that time, I went from being cadet to Krept's cousin and see. Yeah, I was kicking myself because I felt shit, but never said nothing. And like, now we ain't spoken in months. And even advice I can't ask the kid, because I remember your WhatsApp status saying, don't chat to me if you're going to ask for shit. Now around this time, everything's getting loose, feels like with me, you wouldn't.
Your WhatsApp status was, don't chat to me if you're going to ask for shit. He was willing to ask for help. Like, he wanted to ask for help, but because of the WhatsApp status, he was like, ah. Oh. I can't ask him for anything, even if it's help.
Don't chat to me if you're gonna ask for shit. Now around this time, everything's getting loose. Feels like with me, you wouldn't have to do. See, I'm taking bed dicks, but everybody knew I was talking about you. And like every single tune, I was bruised. And then I felt one way, but I still love you to the death. I even got a bar. Even though the love's one way, I still bang you in your face if you're talking about crap. But I guess the blame ain't.
Oh, I'll still bang you in your face if you're talking about Krept, even if the love was... Is that what he said? Even if the love was one way, I'll still bang in your face if you're talking about Krept?
I was talking about you and like every single tune I was bruised. And then I felt one way, but I still love you to the death. I even got a bar. Even though the love's one way, I still bang you in your face if you're talking about Krept. But I guess the blame ain't on you.
That's cold. So, like, even though he's pissed off at him, it's still his family and he's still willing to fuck someone up if they're talking shit about him. I respect that. I respect the fuck out of that.
But even though the love's one way, I still bang you in your face if you're talking about crap. But I guess the blame ain't on you, because not once did I pick up the phone and phone you. I'm happy that you're doing your thing, but as a reminder of all the shit I don't do. So when your videos were hitting a mill, I was still taking bets up in William Hill. Now the jealousy's gone because it's dumb to feel. And the second chapter is where the hunger spills. See, the second chapter's called hunger. And this is when the shit gets peak, because it's when I stopped watching you and I started watching me. But I still got your name like every bar though. Parked up listening to Argue Fargo, and the one time you brought me to wireless was exactly the kick I needed in the arsehole, cause you chose me right over the mandem. Like, even though we ain't spoken long, doing one lucky after you sent the invite, thought you was gonna say my bad one combo, cause then you brought me on stage. It was me, you, and Killer Conan. I was the last one to come off stage, bro, cause up there, man, I felt like home, and I swear since that moment.
Damn. Damn, I was the last one to come up stage, cause I swear it felt like, well, that was home. I fucking love this guy. I said it before, I'll say it again. I don't care how many times I fucking say this. UK has the best hip-hop on the planet. By a mile. Every time. It just blows me away how consistent everyone is over there. It's fucking ridiculous. The US may have started the craft of hip-hop, but UK... fucking mastered it.
The last one to come off stage, bro, cause up there, man, I felt like home, and I swear since that moment, I took shit serious. Stop showing food, quit the muse, quit the fraud. A man them thought I would deliver, you see, I would go.
Ooh, stop shotting food.
I took shit serious. Stop showing food, quit the muse, quit the fraud. A man them
quit the muse.
Thought a moment, I took shit serious. Stop showing food, quit the muse, quit the fraud. A man them
quit the food as well. Okay. I don't know what the muse is, but obviously he stopped selling drugs, stopped doing drugs, and quit the muse. I don't know what the muse is, but obviously it's a crutch for him, whatever it was, but he stopped all that and he started taking music serious.
That moment. I took shit serious. Stop showing food, quit the muse, quit the fraud. A man them thought I would deliver, you see. I would go car park, buy bars, leave the engine on, and then somehow fall asleep. Wake up with a dead battery, get jump started, and then the same night go repeat. To the point now that I ain't even got a car, cause both the battery and the engine's gone. But at least now I'm chasing my dream. I ain't felt like a waste man in long, and the third chapter's called love. Ain't no
I ain't felt like a waste man. That's another fucking unreal slang word that I loved from fucking the UK. Waste man. Like, you're a waste man. Brother, you're a waste man. You're a waste of fucking space. I love that. I fucking love that.
I'm chasing my dream. I ain't felt like a waste man in long. And the third chapter's called love. Love. Ain't no soft shit. Ain't no need for boo-hoos. But when I started loving myself, then I could love you like I used to. Got tired. I've been that waste man rapper in. If I'm a cover boy, I put a grin. And man, I got tired. I go into music events. They don't recognize me for a thing. Man, I got tired. I got tired of feeling like I ain't gonna win. And yo, I got tired. Tired of telling the niggas that I don't know why you don't wanna bring a nigga in. See, I'm just glad that I'm in the same race as you. And the dream is to go and share first place with you. You know, man.
Ooh, I'm just glad I'm in the same race as you. And the dream is to go share first place with you. Fucking hell.
I don't know why you don't wanna bring a nigga in. See, I'm just glad that I'm in the same race as you. And the dream is to go and share first place with you.
Fuck.
You know, man, you're my left lung and there ain't no replacing you. And P.S. I'll still bang everybody in the face for you, man. I love you. You know I love you. You must know this. I love you. You know I love you.
I'm actually just like right now, I can feel tears welling in my eyes. I'm genuinely getting upset that this man doesn't exist on the planet to write music anymore. Like, it's so fucked up, man. We have lost so many fucking good artists. Whether it be to drugs, whether it be to car accidents, whether it be to suicide, it doesn't matter. There is so much that has been lost. Mac Miller, for me, I'm still fucking upset about Mac Miller. Losing Mac was... Whew, that dude was like... My teenage years was listening to Mac Miller. But the point I'm trying to make is, like, we have just lost so many fucking good artists, and it fucking sucks, man. Because going all the way back just to Big L, fucking Big Pun, fucking Tupac, Biggie, you name it. Like, we've lost Guru from Gangsta not long ago. I don't know how many years ago he was, but either way, we've lost so many of these artists and they just aren't putting out music anymore, and it fucking sucks because there's so much music that I know could have been made that would just be legendary status, and it gets me upset.
Body in the face for you, man. I love you. You know I love you. You must know this. I love you. You know 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 I love you. See, you're my cousin. We both came from nothing. We both call me son. You know I love you. 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 See, you're my cousin. We both came from nothing. We both call me son. You know I love you. You know I love you.
I like how he's just whispering that, like, bruh. You know I love you. Both came from nothing. You know I love you. You know. You have to know. And if you don't, you fucking know now. I gotta point out as well, this film clip. It's fucking beautiful. It's well shot. It's well edited. I like the color tones, the color correction that they've used. Like, look at this. This is like fractal. This is looks fucking unreal. But it's just been a really well shot, well edited film clip to go along with a fucking beautiful story. I'm fucking sad that this guy doesn't exist anymore. I'm genuinely sad. But the thing about music, I think that's what makes music so fucking amazing, is the fact that this guy's gonna live on forever. Not in spirit or soul, but through his music, through the words that he managed to get out into the stratosphere. People are able to listen to this. While ever humanity is around, Cadet is gonna be listened to, and I think that's fucking amazing.
Yo, Kazi.
Yo, cuz.
Nah, this is a quick one. I just wanted to tell you I love you, man. Get me more emotional in that band, so I love you, man.
Bro, why you going on some stuffy shit?
Yeah, bro.
I love you too.
Come on. Man, bad. clear, I would walk, you would walk, I would step.
I really, 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 really don't know what is in the water in the UK, but holy fuck, he's right. I've said it in this reaction. I've also said it a million times in other things, but fuck. Again, like, he's another one that's just left me speechless. Nothing I say is going to add any value to what Cadet just did. So, I'm going to dip. I'm going to go record last letter to Cadet. Probably going to get upset in that. But, yeah, if you have enjoyed this reaction, please leave a like. Leave a comment. I don't know why my camera's all fucking fuzzy. There we go. Autofocus is not working sometimes. But yeah, if you did enjoy that reaction, please leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, turn the bell notifications on, and send it around to your homies. If there's any one of your homies that like reactions, if you think they'd enjoy what I do, send it through. Show your dog, show your cat, show your auntie's uncle's goat, show everyone. Much love. I'll see you guys on the next one.